दिस इज एन इंटरेस्टिंग क्वेश्चन विच कैन बी सॉल्व टोटली मेंटली इफ यू नो द कॉन्सेप्ट क्लियरली. हियर इज अ बॉय हु क्लाइम्स द स्लैडर एंड गेट्स डाउन बाय द स्लाइड. वेट ऑफ द बॉय इज गिवन एंड द एवरेज फ्रिक्शन फोर्स बाय द स्लाइड इज गिवन टू बी 3/10 ऑफ हिज वेट. दैट इज 3/10 इंटू 200, दैट कम्स आउट टू बी 60 न्यूटन्स. सो द एवरेज फ्रिक्शन फोर्स दैट इज एक्सर्टेड ऑन द बॉय व्हाइल ही स्लाइड्स डाउन इज 60 न्यूटन्स. द फर्स्ट पार्ट इज we need to find out the work done by ladder on the boy as he climbs. Now when the boy is climbing, the work done by the ladder on the boy will be zero. The reason for this is that work done is always equal to the force exerted into the displacement of point of application of force. Now as the man climbs, there is a normal force acting on his feet. But when the normal force is acting, there is no displacement. And as soon as there is displacement, there is no normal force acting, due to which the net work done by the normal force of the ladder on the man is zero. Always remember this, for finding out work done, there has to be a force and the point of application of force should move while the force is acting on the point of application. So in this case, the answer for the work done by the ladder on the boy as he climbs comes out to be zero. Let's go to the second part. Work done by slide on boy as he comes down. Now the force exerted by the slide on the boy is of two types. One is the normal force and the other is the friction force. But the displacement of the boy is in this direction. But the forces are in two directions, normal and friction. The contribution of normal force towards work done is zero. Because when we take the component of this force with this displacement, it comes out to be zero. Therefore, the only contribution of work done by the slide comes due to this friction force. So we can actually calculate the work done by this friction force on this man to find out the work done by the slide on the boy as he slides down. So the work done by the friction force, this friction force is constant and its value is equal to 60 Newton as we had found out. Because the friction force is given to be 3/10 into the weight of the man, that is equal to 60 newtons. So the displacement is equal to 10 meters, that is already given. So 10 into 60, and we add a minus sign because cos of 180 degree is minus 1. So the work done by the slide on the boy as he comes down comes out to be minus 600 joules. Work done by the slide on the boy as he comes out to be minus 600 joules. Now we need to find out the work done by forces inside boy's body. So we analyze that since a man is not a rigid system, his internal forces can do work. Only in case of non-rigid systems and bodies can there be some work done by the internal forces. Remember this always. So as the man climbs from A to B, as the man climbs from A to B, let us see, work done by all forces equals to change in kinetic energy, that is equal to zero, because initially he was at rest, finally he is at rest. So work done by all forces, what are the forces acting over here which are doing work? One is work done by internal forces plus work done by gravity. There are no other forces acting on the boy who are doing work. There is one force normal whose work done is zero plus work done by normal equal to zero. Work done by normal in this case is zero. Therefore, work done by internal forces is equal to negative of work done by gravity. Now we know that work done by conservative forces is equal to negative of change in potential energy. So we add here minus of minus delta U, that is equal to delta U. Therefore, work done by internal forces of the man is equal to change in potential energy as the man goes from A to B. So this change in potential energy can be written as mg into 8. Now mg is equal to 200 newtons. Therefore, we get the answer as 1600 newtons. Work done by internal forces as the man comes down from here to here is zero. This is joules. Therefore, the work done by internal forces of the man is 1600 joules.